Second Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new." I often think about how different the man I am today is from what I would have been without the transforming power of Christ. My old self is truly dead, just like everyone in this graveyard, but I have been made new. Thank God for His love and for His salvation. I came to know Christ as my Savior at Christian Service Brigade Camp on July 23, 1987 at 9:30 p.m. The gentleman who spoke that evening talked about how we all have sinned and our sin separates us from God. I didn't want to be separated from God, so I raised my hand when he asked if anybody wanted to accept Christ as their Savior. He took us to the dining hall, explained that Christ died for our sins and rose from the dead, defeating death and providing for our salvation. Then he said the sinner's prayer with all of us and had us open up our Bibles to John 3:16 and write down the date and the time so we would always remember our spiritual birthday. It worked because obviously I still remember the day and the time of the most important decision of my life. Since that day, I've strived through the power of the Holy Spirit to live a life worthy of Christ and be an example for him in every area of my life. It was 1989 at summer camp that I first felt called to be in full-time vocational ministry. Through my time in high school, I had that call confirmed several times, so I went to Bible school to be trained. I graduated from Elam Bible Institute in April of 1998 and married my bride that fall. On the advice of our pastor, we decided to wait for a year to get into full-time ministry so we could build a solid foundation for our marriage without the pressure of ministry. We took our first position as a youth pastor in Sterling, Colorado in 1999. Since then, we have been faithfully serving the Lord in any capacity He has seen fit to allow us to minister in. Recently, my wife and I have felt that God is moving us out of youth ministry and into a senior pastor role. After all the years we have served in the church and in the multiple capacities, we feel ready for this challenge. One of my favorite verses is Philippians 3:14, which says, "Not that I have already obtained all this, or have been made perfect, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. Brothers, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead, I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus." One day, I'll reach my final earthly resting place, like all the rest of the people here in the graveyard. But before that happens, I want to make as big of an impact on this world for my Savior as I possibly can.